Welcome back, dear students. Welcome to the lecture 15 of our ongoing course on environmental engineering. Myself, Dhruv Saxena, your course coordinator for this subject. I welcome all of you to the initiative that is Let's Crack the Gate. The initiative is by all the tech faculties that are spread across the nation. Now, today's lecture 15 has been designed in such a way that we learn the various concepts through questions, okay, or you can say numericals. So basically the questions that have been asked in the GATE exam or any of the competitive exam, some major important questions that will be covering the major concepts. So the main goal is to learn how to apply the concepts that we have learned in the previous lectures. What is the application process? What are the things that we need to take care of? So starting with, this was the question I gave you in the previous lecture to solve it, and also I have shared all the questions as a single practice sheet in the Telegram group. I hope many of you must have tried the problems and might have come out with some solutions. So let us now see how do we solve these problems. So what are the important data that are given to us that we need to consider? So first of all, we need to determine here the surface area of this sedimentation tank. The design flow is given as 0.5 meter cube per second. The OFR is given as 32.5 and the detention time is given as 95 minutes. Further, there are some data with regards to L by B ratio and some limitations. So let us see. So to calculate surface area, we can directly use the design flow and the OFR value as per the lectures that we have learned in the previous classes. So your surface area will be equal to your design discharge by the OFR rate. So here it comes out to be 0.5 multiplied by 32.5. Now mind it that this value is in meter cube per meter square per day. So let us convert it into seconds. So what we can do, we can multiply 24 hours into 60 minutes into 60 seconds. So it will convert the value for the surface area in terms of correctly in terms of units. So the value that comes out to be is 1329.8 meter square. I hope you all have also got the same answer. Now we also need to find the depth. To find the depth, what we need to do, we need to calculate what will be the volume. So how can you calculate the volume? Volume capital V can be calculated by using the discharge term and multiplying it with the detention time. Here the detention time is 95 minutes. Okay, so let us convert it. So 0.5 into 95. We will convert these minutes into seconds. So 95 into 60 seconds. What is the final value that we are getting? The answer you must have been getting is 2850 meter cube. Now, using these values, we can calculate what will be the depth of the settling tank. So depth capital H will be given by volume upon surface area. So the volume is 2850 meter cube divided by 1329.8. Okay, this comes out to be around 2.1 meters. Okay, so this is your value for width, the depth. And now using the range of ratio that is given, we assume L by B ratio as 4, and we can put this value 4 times the width multiplied by width will give the surface area. We put the surface area term here to find out the width. Now using this, we find out what is the width. The width comes out to be 18.23 meters, and the length comes out to be 72.9 meters. Now, the last condition is also given that the length should not be less than 100 meters. Sorry, it should not exceed 100 meters. So it is less than 100 meter. Hence, our answers are correct. I hope most of you have got the same answers. Let us move ahead. Let us move on to the second question. So in this, it has been asked that in a continuous flow settling tank, which is 3.5 meter deep, 65 meter long, flow velocity of a water is observed as 1.22 centimeters per second. So what size of particle of specific gravity 2.65 may be effectively removed if the kinematic viscosity is given? Okay. So these are some of the important values that we need to consider before solving. So let us write them down. So H is your 3.5 meters. L is your 65 meter. Okay, then your flow velocity is 1.22 centimeters per second. Value of G is 2.65. Okay, and your kinematic viscosity is 0.01 centimeter square per second. Okay, now here we will be using the Stokes' law. With the help of Stokes' law, we will be able to find out what will be the particle size, okay, which will be effectively removed. So in this case, what I am doing, I am calculating the detention time in terms of length and flow velocity. So 65 meters by 1.22. Per second. This will give you the value in seconds. Using this, what we can do, we can equate this L by VF term to H by VS. Since L, H and VF are known, we can find out a value for VS. Am I right or wrong? So 3.5 meters into 1.22 into 10 to the power minus 2. I have converted centimeters into meters divided by the length, that is 65. The value of VS comes out to be, use the calculators, I have calculated it in advance. So it comes out to be 6.57 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 4 meters per second. Okay. Now further we can simply use directly the Stokes' law, okay. So Stokes' law is given by G minus 1 multiplied by gamma W multiplied by D square divided by 18 mu. Here mu is your dynamic viscosity. So this Vs value today I am teaching using this PowerPoint, so there is a difference in the usage and tools. So this VS is 6.57 into 10 to the power minus 4. The value of G is given as 2.65, so G minus 1 multiplied by the gamma W value, the unit weight of water. It is 9810, okay, multiplied by D square. This is the value which we need to find out. Now in the denominator, we will put the dynamic viscosity. So we need to convert this into kinematic viscosity and also the desired units. The desired units are meter square per second as per the Stokes' law. So I am writing 0.01 centimeter square multiplied by 10 to the power minus 4, it will convert it into meter square in terms of meters, and then I will multiplied by the density of fluid or density of water. So it comes out to be helping us in finding out the value of small d. So the value of small d comes out to be 2.7 into 10 to the power minus 5 meters, or we can write d as 0.27 mm. Now we need to check whether the question, whether the solution we have used, the concepts we have used are correct or not, whether the answer is correct or not. We can check it by ourselves. How? We know that Stokes' law is only valid for diameters less than 0.1 mm. So here the diameter, which turns out to be 0.027 mm as per the solution, so it is less than 0.1 mm. Hence we can easily use the Stokes' law for this type of problem, and we can find out what will be the size of particle that is required. Okay, with this you can convert the kinematic viscosity into dynamic viscosity. Okay, you need to multiply the density of the fluid. Let us move on to the next question. This question has come in GATE of 2014. The question carried 2 marks. Let us read the question. So a suspension of sand-like particles in water with particles of dia 0.1 mm and below is flowing into a settling tank. Your discharge is given. Concern size particles are given. Assume G, gravitational constant. Then specific gravity of particles is 2.65. This meter will not come here. And kinematic viscosity of water is given. Okay. Now we need to find out the minimum surface area in meter square in which the particles of size 0.06, this is your concerned size particle, okay, and above with 100% efficiency will be removed. तो आपको क्या निकालना है, आपको इसमें निकालना है सरफेस एरिया मिनिमम कितना होगा प्लांट के लिए, सेडिमेंटेशन प्लांट के लिए, जिसमें 0.06 mm और उससे ऊपर की साइज के पार्टिकल्स 100% एफिशिएंसी के साथ रिमूव हो जाएं, ठीक है? तो इसके लिए अगेन सिंपल है, अपन स्टोक्स लॉ यूज करेंगे. स्टोक्स लॉ यूज करके अपन सेटलिंग वेलोसिटी निकाल सकते हैं. एक बार सेटलिंग वेलोसिटी मिल गई, उसके बाद में अपने पास डिस्चार्ज है. डिस्चार्ज और सेटलिंग वेलोसिटी वीएस की हेल्प से वी कैन इजीली फाइंड आउट द वेरियस डिफरेंट पैरामीटर्स. ओके, सो लेट अस बिगिन. ओके, सो टू बिगिन विथ लेट अस सॉल्व इट बाय पुटिंग द वेरियस वैल्यूज. नाउ आई एम राइटिंग हियर द एक्सप्रेशन फॉर सेटलिंग वेलोसिटी इन अ लिटिल डिफरेंट फॉर्म. हैव अ लुक एट इट. सो जी माइनस वन टाइम्स gravitational constant times d square divided by 18 nu. Here I have not used the unit weight of water, instead I have used gravitational constant, and in the denominator I have used directly the kinematic viscosity. Hence with the help of this equation, now we don't need to convert the kinematic viscosity into dynamic viscosity. Okay, so let us put in the values to find out the value of settling velocity. So 2.65 minus 1 times your gravitational constant, that is 9.81, multiplied by d square. Now here we can convert the all the values in as per the notations of Stokes law. So we'll convert it into meters. So can I write it, can I write 0.06 mm as 6 into 10 to the minus 5 meters? Now whole square will also come here because d square, and 18 times the kinematic viscosity, which is 1.0105 into 10 to the power minus 2. Now this is in centimeter square, as you can see here, so we need to convert this also in meter square. So I will multiply it by 10 to the power minus 4. So the value of settling velocity comes out to be around 3.204 into 10 to the power minus 3 meters per second. I hope things are clear. Now we can use this settling velocity, and we also know that what is the design discharge or discharge that is flowing in the sedimentation tank, and with this we can find out what will be the surface area. Correct? So surface area, we can write it as design discharge, that is 0.1 divided by 3.204 into 10 to the minus 3, which comes out to be around 31.214 meter cube, sorry, meter square, because we are calculating the surface area. So that is how you solve the numericals for GATE exam. Now next question is again with regards to sedimentation tank. So a plain sedimentation tank with a given length of 20 meters, width is given as 10 meters, and a depth of 3 meters is given in a water treatment plant which is treating around 4 million liters of water per day or 4 MLD. The average temperature is given, dynamic viscosity for that temperature is given. Okay. Keep the eye on the values and the units. What data is given and what units is it given. Then density is given. Okay. Average specific gravity is given. Surface overflow rate has been asked in the sedimentation tank, and this question came in 2007 for 2 marks. So how can you calculate the surface overflow rate? You can easily calculate this OFR value as your discharge divided by the surface area. In our case, it is breadth into length. So your discharge is 4 MLD, 4 million liters. How much does a million, what does a million means? 1 million liter of anything means 10 to the power 6 liter of that thing, okay? So mind this value. Now we have to convert liters into meter cube per second or per day in our case. So 1 meter cube is equal to 1000 liter. So to convert it, we have to multiply it by 10 to the power minus 3. So that our value comes in our desired unit. The breadth is given as 20 meters and the length is given as, sorry, the breadth is given as 10 meters and length is given as 20 meters. So the value for OFR, it comes out to be 20 meter cube per meter square per day. I hope everyone have understood. Quite simple. Surface, this overflow rate has been asked for sedimentation tank, and as per definition we have learned that it is discharge divided by surface area. Now moving on ahead, it has been asked that based upon the data that has been given in question 4, what is the minimum diameter of particle which can be removed with 100% efficiency? So we need to find out the size of concerned size particle. We have to calculate the value of D. Now we will use the Stokes' law. Okay. How we will be using the data that is given. I hope you have taken this down. Let us try to use this various data that has been given. So your settling velocity is given as depth of tank by the detention time. Okay. And also your detention time can be calculated by volume of tank by rate of flow, that is capital V by your discharge value. So using this, the value of detention time comes out to be length into breadth. If we do 20 into 10 into depth, it will give us the volume. Okay. And rate of flow rate of flow is 4 mld. Okay, so we again need to convert it into meter cube per second. So 4 into 10 to the power 6 liters into 10 to the power minus 3, it will convert it into meter cube. And since it is in per day, so we will multiply it by 24 hours into 60 minutes into 60 seconds. So it will convert it into seconds. So the time comes out to be 12960 seconds. Okay. Now we have calculated the detention time. We know the depth. We can calculate the settling velocity. So settling velocity comes out to be depth into, oh sorry, by your h by t, the detention time. So your velocity in mm per second comes out to be 0.2315 millimeters per second. Okay. Now, if we apply the Stokes law for concerned size particle, we can get the required values. G minus 1 multiplied by, in this case, what is given? In this case, we have been given with dynamic viscosity, okay? So, we can directly use the value of gamma W. It all depends upon which value is given. You can do the problem that way. So gamma W time d square by 18 mu. So this comes out to be 2.65 minus 1 multiplied by 9810 multiplied by d square by the dynamic viscosity value, which is 1.002 into 10 to the power minus 3. 1.002 into 10 to the power minus 3. What are the units? Units are Newton second per meter square. Okay. Now mind it that here density of water is given as 998.2. Okay. So instead of 9810, we will be using, so we will use this value. We will use this 998.2. Okay. Now equating it with the available value, that is 2315 into 10 to the minus 3 meters per second. I have converted into meters per second. So the value of your small d comes out to be 16 into 10 to, please calculate it once by yourself also, what is the value that you are getting. It should come around 16 into 10 to the minus 3 mm. Okay, moving on ahead, we have a question based upon hardness and alkalinity. So in this question, read it once. So for a sample of water with the ionic composition that is given, which is shown in the figure, we need to find out the concentrations of carbonate and non-carbonate hardness in terms of milligrams per liter as CaCO3. What is given to us is the concentration of these multivalent cations and sodium ions, and it is also given the milli equivalents of the anions. Okay. So from this, since non-carbonate hardness is present here, which is due to, non-carbonate hardness is due to sulfates. So we can conclude that since non-carbonate hardness is present, hence the sodium alkalinity is absent. Now what does it mean? Sodium alkalinity is absent. It means that the HCO3 that is given here, none of it is making a compound with sodium ion. The entire HCO3 minus is being used with calcium or magnesium. Okay. So this NaH CO3 is zero. Okay, now using this, for this carbonate hardness, we can find out the carbonate hardness as now this is in milliequivalent. Okay, so we will convert it into equivalent, and then we will multiply it by the equivalent weight. Equivalent weight for bicarbonate is 50 grams. We will convert it into milligrams. So again, 10 to the 3 I am writing. milligrams per liter. Okay, per 1 liter. So your carbonate hardness comes out to be 175 milligrams per liter as CaCO3. This 50 was your equivalent weight for calcium carbonate. Okay, and you have multiplied the equivalent number of equivalents of bicarbonates to convert it into a value which is equal to calcium carbonate value, in terms of calcium carbonate value. Now, what is the second thing asked? Second thing asked is non-carbonate hardness concentration. Now, how can we calculate the non-carbonate hardness concentration? We know that non-carbonate hardness is equal to total hardness minus the carbonate hardness. So, we have calculated the carbonate hardness. We can calculate the total hardness as well. How can we calculate the total hardness? Total hardness will be the hardness that is because of the multivalent cations. So in this question, calcium and magnesium are the only multivalent cations, and their milliequivalents number is, concentration is 5. So we will convert it into equivalents, and then we will multiply it with the equivalent weight of calcium carbonate, and thus we will get the final value as 250 milligrams per liter as CaCO3. Okay, there might be a possibility of visibility for this value, so I am writing this value here. Okay, this comes out to be 250 milligrams per liter concentration. So you can find out the value of NCH as 250 minus 175, which turns out to be 75 milligram per liter as CaCO3. So the correct answer for this is B. Carbonate hardness is 175 and non-carbonate hardness is 75. So that's all for this session. In this lecture, we have learned various things with regards to concepts, how to apply them in the gate problems. So with the next lecture, we'll be starting with coagulation and flocculation processes. So that's all for this lecture. See you in the next one.